Phoebe. Phoebe, dodge. Dodge, Phoebe. Phoebe. Dodge, Phoebe. Bravo, Phoebe. Stai là, disti.
We are Tamara and David, an Anglo-Balkan couple who live in a village in beautiful northern Bosnia and Herzegovina.
Here on our channel, we take you along with us during our daily lives and also to the places we discover on our trips away.
From everyday life to culture and food, we'll show you what it's like for us living in this much misunderstood country.
We're looking forward to you joining us. Remember to subscribe and hit the notification bell so you never miss a video.
Evo ga, idem na YouTube.
Da?
Da, pa evo ga. Ako se ovako drži malo... Malo sine ovo digne dvije.
Vidiš?
Vidim ovo ste.
Okay. I što sitno, to sve treba.
Pa sve će to leći.
Mam ja sitno sito, kogazu.
Nema to, ne može sito, sine, i niko ne može ovo procijeti. Ovo se mora leći da vino bude bistro.
This is very dangerous.
Don't drink it then. Nemojem da pita koja je opasna. Oh my god.
It's lovely.
It's still young.
But you can taste the alcohol, right?
Mm-hmm.
No.
Good. It's good you're gonna go to the toilet like really fast.
Apparently this is a Balkan laxative. I won't be filming that. What's underneath here then? Oh, sausages.
Sausages and some shawa.
Name a shish.
Name, I didn't have any shish. Sorry. Sorry, that's here we go. Cut a cabbage triangles with the Krajinska kobasica.
Mm-hmm.
And some soya sauce and spices.
And sesame seeds on the top.
And sesame seeds on the top.
Very tasty, I've just had mine for breakfast.
And a whole wheat pastry.
Mm-hmm. Where do you get the idea of this from? This is not Bosnian food.
Yeah, we do have kupus pita.
Really?
Yeah.
Never had that in all these years. You're gonna make kupus pita in the future?
I will. This is just from the leftover of the pastry I bought. It was not very good.
Mm-hmm. Is it phyllo pastry? Because I saw you...
Phyllo pastry, yes. And I slice it into like noodles.
Mm-hmm.
And I just put some eggs, the remains of the kupus pita.
Mm-hmm.
And some pavlaka and a little bit of milk.
Pavlaka is like sour cream, right?
Yes. Stop. There we go.
So it's a Tuesday. Oh yeah, welcome back to the vlog. It's a Tuesday, it's miserable outside, raining, overcast. Hopefully we're gonna get some more good days. I talk about this all the time. One of the things I wanna talk about now though are answering some of the questions that you send either on the YouTube comments. Thank you very much indeed for those. And also where we are on both the Facebook page and the Facebook group. Now, as a result of the last vlog where we were baking rakia, John Dowling sent a comment. So, yeah. And John says, is personal distilling regulated at all in Bosnia and Herzegovina as it is here in the United States? There's a straight answer to that. No, it's not regulated. Everybody seems to do it without any interference from the state or from the police or anywhere. Apparently, so the rumour goes, when Tito was in charge, when it was a communist country, maybe there was, I don't know, some interference. But that is only a rumour and a legend. But this rakia baking, distilling fruit, has been going on for almost ever, I think. So that's that. The second thing that John asked was, do you source all of your fruit right from your own properties? And is the distilling a communal effort among several neighbours with shared results for all? Some people who have big properties, they just do their own fruit. We here, Tam's father Predrag, has got a plum orchard. If you follow the vlogs, check them back on the playlist, you'll see that this year, the same as last year, we had a pretty dim plum harvest, so we didn't make any shliv of it, so we just didn't have enough plums. But there's a lot of apples on this property, and the neighbour as well. So this year, it was all about apples. And as far as I'm aware, everybody shares the apples together, and then they divvy out the percentage of how much apples was put in. Does that make any sense? Yeah. Okay, so that's that. It's a communal effort. As for leaf peeping, my fall in 2002 in the Tuzla area, I have to say that John was here in 2002 in Tuzla, which is a city quite some way away from where we are here. He was with the Americans there. My fall in the Tuzla and surrounding region reminded me of a great deal of being back home in Western and Central Pennsylvania. How cool is that? That here in Northwest Bosnia with something similar to Central Pennsylvania. I think though, John, to be honest, you've got a lot more huger areas of woodland and forestry for all those wonderful autumn colours. But here in Bosnia Herzegovina, we do well, we do well. Thanks for the rakia, a nice vlog. Thank you very much for that comment. I enjoyed watching the baking. Thank you once again. So John, thanks. And thank you for all the comments, likes and thumbs up that you're giving us. And the more we get of that, the better this channel is, because we would like to grow it. We're on 2,681 subscribers at the moment. We'd like to grow that. And it's this, what they call the algorithm, this piece of technology that runs in the background that offers our videos to other people. So if you would share them with friends or recommend them, that would be really good. The longer you watch, that is also very good for us as well. That's it for this video on another miserable autumn day, but it's still lovely to live here nevertheless. Please share, like and subscribe. Press the notification button on YouTube so you'll never miss the notification of when we've posted a video. And we will see you in the next one. Stay safe wherever you are. These are still very challenging times. Bye for now.